houses and office buildings are producing more energy than the amount of energy they consume. Such is TNO's ambition, in order to meet national and international climate agreements. The energy agreement is about having an energy-neutral environment by the year 2050. But TNO is raising the bar. Building the energy-positive house. To this end, TNO has teamed up with national and international parties and will be actively involved at three levels. Maximizing the process of energy generation, optimizing storage, and minimizing energy consumption while maintaining a comfortable and healthy indoor climate. Storage is one of the main technological challenges. In a European consortium of large and small businesses, universities and knowledge institutions, TNO has been the first in the world to realize a prototype operational system based on salt hydrates, which has been tested on this scale, the heat battery. With this system, we are able to store heat generated during the summer using solar thermal collectors, without thermal losses. In the winter season, the stored heat is used for heating purposes and also for hot tap water. This breakthrough has been achieved by impacting the properties of selected salt hydrates as such, making them suitable for repeated storage and delivery of heat. This is called thermochemical storage. A thermal storage system consists of two tanks interconnected inside a closed system. One of these tanks contains salt, the other contains water. The system also comes with a boiler tank and control unit. By opening the tap during the winter, salt and water are brought together. The water evaporates. The water vapor binds to the salt and heat is released. This process is called hydration. The released heat is discharged into the boiler tank. The hot water inside the boiler can be used for central heating or hot tap water. After hydrating the maximum amount of water in the salt, no more heat will be released. The system is empty. To recharge the system, water and salt need to be separated once more, using solar heat during the summer. Sun rays are absorbed by a solar collector. The heat from the solar collector is used to separate water and salt. The heat makes the water evaporate from the salt. The vapor moves on to the water tank and condenses there. If the tap is closed, the water will be trapped, unable to reach the salt. This process is called dehydration. The system has recharged. Solar heat is now chemically stored in the dry salt, at room temperature. No heat is lost throughout the period of storage. Storing solar heat for future use without any loss is a leap when it comes to making houses and buildings energy positive.